Sunset over the water, tangerine-hued, peaceful, but reflective as well of a certain trepidation ever since a fictional sunset swim in 1975. A primal fear, an enemy below the surface, but frankly, little understood, less man-eating monster than instinctive apex predator.
I've been interested in sharks my whole life. And
you may recognize biologist Greg Skomel. He works for the Massachusetts Division of Marine Fisheries and runs its shark research program. Working in public-private partnership with the nonprofit Atlantic White Shark Conservancy, they've been able to tag about 350 white sharks since the great whites returned to New England waters a little over a decade ago.
Slowly, over the course of the last 50 years, we have been rebuilding seal populations with the Marine Mammal Protection Act that passed in 1972. And, you know, white sharks eat seals. And so you show me a restaurant that big and I'm going to show you the customers, and that's what the white sharks are. They're coming in to these shorelines to feed on the seals.
The sharks are tagged with acoustic tags that will ping their location for years, and with video tags that will record for a couple of days and then pop to the surface. The tagging itself can be challenging.
Nope, bent the needle. Bad angle, my fault.
Just finding sharks can be a challenge. A spotter plane is in the air for the entirety of our six-hour trip off Chatham. When the pilot spots a shark, he guides the boat captain to intercept.
He's curious. He's like, he wants to know who we are.
Look at that.
Wow. For this shark, Skomel sets up both acoustic and video tags. And with patience and skill, tags a new shark.
Yeah!
Love it!
They're really just big fish that are hunting for their natural prey items.
Megan Winton is the senior scientist at the White Shark Conservancy.
So a big part of our mission at the Conservancy is not only to study these animals and learn more about them from a biological perspective, but also to use that information to kind of replace fear with facts, because they're very different from the way they're typically portrayed in the media.
The research is important because remarkably little is known about a creature that lives rent-free in all our imaginations. Where do they mate? How long is a pregnancy? Where are the young born? And yes, they are responsible for the occasional bite or tragic fatality, like the death of 26-year-old Arthur Medici in Wellfleet in 2018.
We're very, very interested in trying to enhance public safety by better understanding the behavior, the biology of this animal. And that's what these tags are telling us. They're giving us a sense of where these sharks are in time and space. You know, when do they arrive on Cape Cod? Where do they spend their time? When do they leave? How does that change from year to year? How does that change in a changing environment? Right? Those are all critical questions.
One remarkable thing the research has discovered is that great whites off the Cape spend about half their time in water that is just 15 feet deep or less.
Which really took a lot of people by surprise. We want to learn more about these animals and their behavior and how they're hunting for seals in the shallow waters off of Cape Cod beaches. So we can provide that information to the towns, to public safety officials, and most importantly to the public, so they understand what it is these animals are doing in the shallow waters off of our beaches.
Shark location data from the acoustic tags is stored in these receiver buoys and retrieved annually. These real-time receivers are used to alert local communities about shark activity and populate the much-used Sharktivity app created and maintained by the Conservancy. Volunteers like Brian Hansen, who is also a Conservancy board member, play a critical role in helping the team, while also satisfying his own fascination with great whites.
Having a healthy ocean, a healthy ecosystem is so important, and with white sharks being the apex predator of these oceans here, I think we need to know as much as we can about them.
With research, outreach, and education, the Conservancy is busy on and off the water and is helping to shine light where once there were only shadows.
Just seeing these sharks is really cool, and then being able to put a tag on them and then get to know that animal over the course of many years to come and what it does and learn from it, take that knowledge and turn it into, you know, meaningful information. That never gets dull for me. I love it.
Hey, there we go.
Yeah!
So fascinating, and it's really interesting that these sharks, maybe even a little scary, are spending so much time in shallow water.
Yeah, it's sobering, but remember, they're looking for seals. They're not looking for people. It's really believed that most bites of people are cases of mistaken identity. Megan also says they found out that sharks are really inquisitive, but of course they don't have hands, so the only way they can really investigate something is with their mouths. So sometimes, whether it's a lobster buoy or a bite of a human, it's just an investigative thing, but that can be very dangerous for a human.
All right, next, this life jacket is a lifesaver.